provide the given address lines to offset and the block number. All these we'll see in this slide. The given configuration in the textbook is cache is having a 128 blocks of 16 words. It means the total size of the cache is 2K, 2048. How I got this? 128 blocks into 16. If you multiply 128 into 16, multiplied with 16, you'll be getting an answer of 248. Or else if they are going to give you directly the cache size and if they are going to tell you the word size, each word size, then also you can decide how many blocks will be there. For example, 2048 divided by 16 will give you 128. But you should know how to get these values. But they are going to give at least any of the two values, either the block size and the number of blocks and the block size, which I call it as a word in this, and or else they are going to give you the total size of the cache or the total size of the memory and the number of words in each block, which will give you total number of blocks. Similarly, they have given 64K of RAM, 64K of RAM, and to address this 64K, how many address lines are required? I have told this before in the first video, basic concepts, where I have told how to get this. 2 to the power of what will give me 64K? 64K means 65,536. 2 to the power of 16 will give me 64K. It means there are 16 address lines, 16-bit address lines are required to address 64K. And we know the word size. The word size will not vary from RAM to cache. The word size is fixed. The whatever the word size we are going to take, that is fixed from RAM to cache, it will not vary. So that is already told that 16 words are there in each word line. So what I have to do now? Then divide the, take up the same 16 words, divide the 64K by 16, I'll be getting total number of blocks available in the main memory. I'm having a 4K blocks in the main memory. 4K blocks in the main memory, 128 blocks in the cache memory. You can see the difference now. The total size of the cache is 2K and the total size of the main memory is 64K. By taking this 16 bits, let's divide into different parts. As I have discussed in the first video, if I take up a 32-bit address, the 30 bits are used to recognize the word and 2 bits are used to recognize the byte inside the word, right? Similarly, out of this 16, how much I need? See, 2 to the power of 16 will give me 65,536. Out of that 16, I told there are 16 words inside, right? 16 words inside each word, whatever we take. So, how to get that 16? 2 to the power of 4 will give me 16. Out of 16, I have taken 4 bits to recognize the inside blocks. Inside block offset, I have taken this. And individual block, how I am going to recognize? Remaining 12 bits, that is 4K I said. 4K, 2 to the power of 12 will give me 4K. Remaining 12 bits are used to recognize the block number. Out of, see, 12 bits are sufficient to address 4K. And 4 bits are sufficient to address 16 words. Totally, I need 16 bits to address 64K. This is how the given address bits are divided in main memory. This is in main memory. Again, in cache, this is going to vary from a mapping function to one mapping function to another mapping function. The first and the easiest mapping function is direct mapping. This is the example which has given in the textbook. So I'll take up one more simple example and I'll discuss. First, we have already seen we are having a 1496. It means 4K blocks in the main memory. This is main memory and it starts from 0 to 1495. It means I'm having 1496, 4K blocks over here. And when it comes to cache, I'm having 128 blocks according to the discussion. That 128 ranges from 0 to 127. Out of given 16-bit address, what I am going to do now? How I am going to divide the address? The word size, whatever I said, it is 16 word. That is standard even in main memory, even in cache. So that 4 bits is reserved here. I won't change them. The remaining 12 bits. Out of remaining 12 bits, how many blocks? So how many word lines I am having over here in the cache? So I'm having total 128. How to get 128? 2 to the power of 7 will give me 128. To recognize each word line here, each word line, which we may call it as a block also, here we are going to require 7 bits, remaining 5 bits. Remaining 5 bits will go to tag lines. So what is the use of these tag lines? What is the use of this block? All this we'll see now. See, out of the blocks, whatever is there in the main memory, that is 0 to 1495, if I want to place that in the small cache, how I can place with the help of direct mapping? First, what I have to do? You have to take any block you want to place. For example, I'll take a block 129. I want to place it on this. So I don't have a block number 129 over here. I don't get that because this is a limited memory compared to this main memory. Now what I have to do? I have to somehow make a space over here so that I can store this in the cache. To do that, we need some standard technique, right? Directly, I cannot, blindly, I cannot go and I can place it on the cache. For that, direct mapping is going to tell, take a modulus from the total number of blocks. The total number of blocks in the cache is 128. If I take up modulus, if I take up 129 modulus 128, the remainder will be 1. So, I have to go to the block number 1. Here, I can store the block number 129. So this is how I'm going to decide. For example, let me take 256. 256, I want to place it on the cache. How I can decide where to place? Let's take a 256 remainder with a 128. I will get the value 0. When I get the value 0, where I will store? I will store at the block number 0 over here. And if I take some block number 4, if I take block number 4 over here from this, I can take a modulus from 128. So the remainder will be 4. So I'll be storing in the block number 4. This is how direct mapping is going to perform. So only simple task, take a modulus with the memory block number and generate a remainder and decide the respective cache block will be having the memory block which is retrieved from the main memory. This is how it's going to place the main memory blocks on the cache memory. And here, as I said, the low out of 16, lower order 4 bits are determined out of the 16 to tell the respective word. And next 7 bits are going to decide which block it is. I said 0, 1, 2, 1, 127 now. So how I am going to get that? With the help of 7 bits. Next is the important one. This high order 5 bits, the high order, not MSB side. The LSB side will go to recognizing the words inside the each word line, and the in between are going to be used for the recognizing the blocks inside the cache, and the last 5 bits from the MSB part are used to decide the hit and miss of the given block. So here the high order bits of the address are compared with the tag bits. Whenever a processor is requesting for a block, it's going to generate a 16 lines, 16 address lines. It's going to generate a 16 bit address, and out of that it will take a first 5 order bits and it's going to compare with the tag lines over here. Tag lines, this tag lines it's going to compare. If it's going to match, if those tag lines are matching, then that respective block is available in the cache. If it is available in the cache, which we have seen in the previous video itself, whatever we are requesting, if it is available, then it's a hit. If it is not available in the cache, then it is a miss. It means what we have to do, we have to fetch the data from main memory to cache with the help of, again, mapping function. And what, which block to be replaced, that is in the direct mapping, it is going to be decided by the modulus function. And the advantage of this direct mapping is here less comparator will be used. We have heard a term called comparator, which is a which is there in the logic AD subject. There the job of the comparator is to compare with the existing address with the address which are available in the cache. So this is going to have a less number of comparators compared to other two techniques. The hardware required for direct mapping is less. But it is having major disadvantages also. It is not flexible. It's going to suffer with the concept of the major disadvantage called conflict miss or capacity miss. It means even though there are empty spaces in the cache, always I'll be targeting only one respective block, and always I try to access only that. So even though the remaining memories are free, remaining blocks in the cache is free, I will not use it. With the example, I will explain in the next slide. Let's take an example. Consider for the 32-bit architecture, whatever we are discussing throughout this subject, the memory configuration is given. The main memory is having 64 bytes. I have reduced because for the discussion, if I am going with a huge memory, then the discussion will not be effective. So I thought to reduce. So 64 bytes of main memory is there, and cache memory is having 16 bytes. This is the size of the main memory and the cache memory. Now what we have to do is we have to find the number of address lines required for this. 64 means 2 to the power of what will give me 64, so that will be the number of address lines, and apply the direct mapping for the cache. So the given block request, the block requests are in this range, the block number 4, 8, 12, 8, 24, 16, 36, 16, 4, 8, 12, 8, 24, 16, 36, 16. I have intentionally taken these numbers to show the disadvantage of direct mapping. And what we have to do is, after using this direct mapping algorithm, list which are the blocks available in the cache at the end of this sequence. Once we finish this sequence, once I come to the last block number, last request 16, which are all the blocks which are available on the cache I have to show. And I have to show hit rate and miss rate. How many times I got the blocks which I requested on the cache. That is a hit. How many times I have been forced to bring the block from the main memory to cache, which is a miss rate. So these we have to count. Let's calculate these address lines and all. The number of address lines required to address 64 is 6. We know that 2 to the power of 6 will give me 6 address lines. And we are having a 32-bit architecture. It means one word means it's 4 bytes. We have seen this from the first module. So here, because we are taking a 32-bit architecture, we are having a 32-bit is the word size. So it is nothing but 4 bytes. When I take up 64 by 4, the one word size, I'll be getting 16 blocks. It means my main memory is having 16 blocks. And out of 6 bits, how many bits are required to represent the block offset? So I am having 4 bytes of block offset, 4 bytes. To generate address, I am, for me, 2 bits are more than enough to generate 4 values, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So 2 bits are sufficient. And remaining 4 bits, 2 to the power of 4 is going to be 16. So I am getting a 16 blocks over here. This is with respect to main memory. The main memory given 6 bits is divided into 2 parts. One is for the block offset, that is 2 bits. And remaining 4 will go to block number. Next, with respect to cache, we are having 16 bytes is the cache size. So with, if I divide with the one word size, I'm going to get 4 blocks in my cache. So again, the given address we are going to divide. The 2 bits, as like in the main memory, it is constant. And to get the 4 blocks, so 2 bits more is enough for me. And tag bits for hit and miss, I need remaining 2 bits for the hit and miss, which are used as the tag lines. This is with respect to cache in direct mapping example. Now let's see, we'll start applying a direct mapping technique on the given sequence of a block list request. The first block which is requested in the question is 4. The 4 is there in the main memory. We have to bring it to the cache. So For that, what we have to do is, first we have to take 4 and the number of blocks in this, which we have calculated before, in the cache is 4, take a modulus 4 from 4, the answer will be 0, then it's going to decide where that block should reside. So, the block number 4 is residing on the line number, I will call this as line number on the 0. Next number will, the next number is 8. Again, if I take 8 modulus 4, the answer is 0 and it's going to overwrite 4, and the miss rate, previously the 4 I requested which was not there, so it was 1. So now 8 is requested, 8 is also not there in the cache, so it's going to be increased by 2. So now 8 has acquired the place of 4. And next, 12. So 12, if you take up a modulus with 4, the answer will be 0. Again, it's going to use the tag number 0 or word line number 0. And now again, 12 is not available in the cache. That's why we are going to increase the miss rate by 1. Now 12 we got in the cache. Next request. Next we are having 8. So again, if I take 8 modulus 4, I'm going to get 0. Again, it's going to overwrite line number 0, and it is 8 is not available in the cache, so miss rate is increased by 1. Similarly, if I take up for 24, again 24 modulus 4 is 0. Now again, it's going to overwrite the word line 0, and the miss rate will be increased by 1. Similarly, if I apply for the remaining block request, 16, again the modulus, if you take 0, 36, if I take modulus 4, it is also 0, again 16, 0, again 4, it is 0, again 8, it is 0, 12, 0, and 8 is also 0, 24 modulus 4 is also 0, 16 modulus 4 is also 0, 36 modulus 4 is also 0. It means in all these requests, so only line number in the cache 0 is used. Rest all the remaining 4 lines, 3 lines are not used. And I'm having total 16 requests here. Already I have covered 15 requests. So the miss rate is increased to 15. There is no hit, because if I would have utilized these empty location, then I would have got a hit rate. I would have got 1 or 2 hit rate. But because I'm using only one line, because of that modulus function, whatever I'm applying, so because of that, I'm always forced to use word line 0 with a direct mapping technique. This is going to lead the increase in the number of miss rather than getting some hit rate. So now if I'm going to place this 16, again, miss rate will be increased to 16. And now, even though you can see at this moment, I'm having only 16 in the cache. This is the current snapshot, and hit rate is 0. 16 is the miss rate. This is what is they have asked in the question. For this given values, apply the direct mapping technique. Find the respective line number where the requested block from the main memory should reside in the cache by applying the modulus technique. Then after, just keep on counting how many hits and how many misses. Now here we had a 16 request, we got all 16 are missing. There is no hit. All 16 has to bring every time from the main memory to cache memory. And even though I was having an empty space in the cache, there are 3 more word lines which were free in the cache, but still, because of the modulus function operation of the principle of the direct mapping, I am unable to use the remaining. So this is what is the major drawback of the direct mapping, which I told conflict miss, or we have told capacity miss. Even though we are having a capacity to store the remaining blocks contiguously, we could not because of the direct mapping modulus technique. But it is easy to implement. There is no big trick required over here. Just find the modulus of the given block number with the number of block, maximum number of the block in the cache, and you will get some value. Based on that, apply the comparator, use the comparator hardware, and store the value in the cache. But here we are not fully utilizing the cache. This is the major drawback of the direct mapping. The drawback of the direct mapping is overcome by the associative mapping, where for the same configuration, whatever I have discussed, so here we are going to use associative mapping. The associative mapping is not going to be like the direct mapping. Here we don't use any technique called modulus to decide where to place the block from main memory to cache. So here the associative mapping goes with the technique where it's going to find the empty space from 0 to n in the cache, and it's going to store the blocks. What happens if all the blocks are utilized? Then it's going to apply a replacement algorithm, which I have told in the previous video. The replacement algorithm which is going to be discussed here is LRU, least recently used, which is not used very frequently. That respective block will be removed in the associative mapping. We'll see this with an example in the next slide. Before that, the given 16 word lines, as we divided in the direct mapping, similarly we are going to divide over here. The first 4 bits are given to word offset, which is standard like a main memory. The remaining 12 bits, will be given to directly for the tag bit. There is no extra division of block number and tag. It's completely given to tag bit, because we are not going to use any modulus operation over here. Here directly we are applying the associative mapping on the free location. If there is no free location, then we have to call the one more algorithm called replacement algorithm, which is the LRU, least recently used. That is going to decide which block out of those 127 blocks should be removed, and that respective block space will be given to the newly requested block. Let's see for the same example what we have discussed with our direct mapping. We'll be using the same sequence of requests, and we'll see how many hits and how many miss rate will be there, and what is the snapshot, what is the final available blocks on the cache. So here what we have to do is we have to apply the associative mapping on the same sequence, and we'll calculate the things in the same as like direct mapping. There are 64 bytes of memory in the main memory, so I need 6 address lines. So it's a 32-bit architecture. I need 4 bytes to store in one word. So 64 by 4 will give me 16 blocks. And next, the given blocks in the main memory, we are going to, the given address in the main memory, we are going to divide into 2 parts. One is the block offset, and one more is the block number. The block offset is going to have 2 bits, where the 4 bytes will be addressed, and the block number is going to have 4 bits, which is going to give the 16 blocks. Similarly, when it comes to cache, we are going to have 16 by 4, that is 4 blocks. 16 is the cache size and 4 is the word size, and divided by 4, I'll be getting 4 blocks. And as I said, here we don't have a 3 division in the cache for the address. We are having only 2 division. The block offset is a standard which is remains as like main memory, and the remaining 4 bit directly goes to tag number. Now we'll see the associative mapping. So let's take a first request. The first request is 4, and here no calculation, directly it's going to store the 4 in the first available free location, that is 0th location. And I'm using one more algorithm, array over here to remember who is used frequently, which is a least recently used algorithm. So I'm now the request is for 4. This is going to be the recently used. So I'm going to add this to the array. And now the 4 is requested. 4 is actually not there in the cache, so it has to retrieve from the main memory. So hit count should be increased to, miss count should be increased to 1. Now let's see for the next request. Now 8 is requested. The next available space is word line number 1. So 8 will be stored over there, and 8 will be added to LRU, and miss rate will be increased. When it comes to 12, 12 can be placed in next empty location 2, and which will be added to LRU, and miss rate will be increased. Now let's take 8. 8 is requested, but 8 is already there in the cache. Now I need not to bring the memory block 8 from main memory to cache memory. It is already available. So 8 is recently used, because just now it is entering to the cache. So it is recently used, but I need not to add it to the miss rate, because it is available. I am going to increase the hit rate. Next, 24 next available empty location is the third. What I will do is I'll bring up 24 and I'll increase the miss rate, and I'll add it to the least recently used is 24. Next, there is a request for 16. So there is no space. 4, 8, 12, 24 has acquired all 4 available word lines. What I have to do right now? So I have to check what has to be replaced among these 4. So you can check out here, the least recently used is 4, which has been entered the cache in the beginning. So I am authorized to remove this based on the replacement algorithm LRU. So now replace 4 with 16 and increase miss rate. Yes. Request is for 36, and for 36 again there is no empty space, which has to be removed. See the LRU. The next least recently used block is 12, which can be removed. So we can remove 12 and we can increase the miss rate, and we can add up 36 in the 12th place. Request is 16. 16 is already available in the cache. I need not to bring that from the main memory to cache. What I can do is just to read whatever the 16 is required and increase the hit rate and add 16 to the least recently used queue. Now I got 2 hits. Next request is 4, and there is no space in the cache. So I have to find a space, apply the replacement algorithm LRU. LRU is going to tell 8 can be replaced. So the 8 is replaced with 4, and now 4 is not available in the cache. So miss is increased by 1. Next, take up 8. So again, 8 is not available in the cache. So I have to replace using the replacement algorithm. Replacement algorithm is suggesting 24 is the least recently used. So what I have to do is I have to replace 24 by 8 and increase the miss rate by 1. 12 is the request. So for 12 again we don't have a space. 36 is the least recently used block, which we can replace and increase the miss rate by 1. Next request is for 8. 8 is already exist in the cache, so this is a hit. So what I have to do is I have to increase his hit and change the order of the 8. 8 should be just recently added. And next block is 24. 24 is not available in the cache, so I have to find a place. If I go through the replacement algorithm, it's going to suggest 16 should be replaced. So I'm going to replace the 16 block with 24 and increase the miss rate by 1. Next, the request is for 16. So 16 is not available in the cache. Again, find the next available, removable block, that is 4. So replace 4 with 16 and increase the miss rate. Next request is for 36. Again, 36 is not available in the cache. So what we have to do is increase the miss rate, and by the help of LRU, find which block should be replaced, that is 12, and add up the 36 to the place of 12. Now the miss rate is 12 and hit rate is 3. The last block request, 16, which is already available in the cache, no need to bring that from the main memory to cache. Here what we can do is we can just increase the hit rate and update the LRU. And now this is the final. At this given moment, we are having how many hits? I'm having 4 hits, 12 misses compared to previous algorithm, direct mapping. In direct mapping, we had 16 misses, 0 hits. But with the help of associative mapping, we got more hits compared to the previous one. And also, we got the snapshot of the cache where all the word lines of the cache is well utilized. Here, there is no conflict miss. This is the advantage of associative mapping. But the disadvantage of this associative mapping is, here what we need is, we need more comparators to check with the cache. So the hardware requirement for the associative mapping is more compared to direct mapping. Direct mapping is simple, hardware requirement is less. When it comes to requirement is less with respect to hardware, it means the cost of building that algorithm is less. But the building cost of the developing cost of associative algorithm is more compared to direct mapping. But direct mapping having a disadvantage of conflict miss or capacity miss, but associative mapping is having a disadvantage of demanding more comparators. These two advantages can be overcome, and these two disadvantages can be overcome, and advantages can be added in the next algorithm, set associative mapping, which is a combination of both direct mapping and associative mapping. So here we are going to decide a set, and we will be taking a cache. We'll divide into number of sets, and on each set we are applying direct mapping to decide which set it has to, the block has to enter. Inside that particular set, which block it has to acquire, that is decided by the associative mapping. That is why it is a combination of direct mapping and associative mapping. First apply direct mapping to decide the set, then apply associative mapping to decide the block or word line. So for the same given configuration, we were having 16 address lines. So out of that, 4 is given to word. And here, how many sets we are having? 64 sets we are having. Why 64? Here, this configuration should be given from the question, that they should tell set means collection of how many blocks. Here the set means it's a collection of 2 blocks. Totally how many blocks I was having in the cache? That is 128. If you group them by 2, then you will be having 64 sets. So 64 sets, 2 to the power of 6, that is going to be 6 bits are enough to address the 64 sets, and remaining 6 will go to tag line, as like direct mapping. I told it this is a combination of direct mapping and set associative. That's why again tag line has come into picture over here. The job of the tag line is to decide whether the given block is available on the cache or not by comparing the first MSB bit of 6 address bits with the existing bits, address bits in the cache. Let's see the example. See here, the example is again taken with the same sequences whatever I have taken in the previous case. And why I have taken the same sequences is just I want to highlight the advantage and disadvantage of the previous algorithms. So here the same 32-bit architecture machine is used with 64 bytes of memory and 16 bytes of cache. And the set size, this is mandatory. You should know the set size when you are applying a set associative mapping. The set size is 2 words. It means 2 words is equal to 1 set. Let's find the address lines. We have already know that 2 to the power of 6 is 64. 6 address lines are required. And 1 word means 4 bytes in the 32-bit architecture. 64 by 4 is going to give you 16 blocks in the main memory. And that 6 bits is divided into 2 parts. One is a block offset, which is used with the 2 bits to represent 4 bytes of word, and 4 bits for 16 blocks. And coming to cache, we are having a 16 bytes of cache divided by 4 is going to give you 4 blocks. And number of sets, we are having 4 blocks, and number of sets is given by the total number of blocks available in the cache divided by the set size will give you total number of sets available in the cache. It means 4 by 2, 2 is given by the question, 4 I got from this calculation 16 by 4, so I have got a 2 sets. It means in this discussion I am having 2 sets. The previous discussion I said it is 64, but in this example with this architecture I am having 2 sets in this cache. And we can see over here the block offset is constant compared as like main memory, and the set number I have taken only 1 bit. Why? Because I'm having only 2 sets, 0 or 1, so 1 bit is sufficient for me to represent the set number, and remaining 3 bit will go to remaining all bits, whatever it is, it will go to tag number. Let's see the example. First take up the block request 4, which is not there in the cache. What I have to do, I have to bring that from the main memory to cache. Now what I have to do, first here also I said I'm making use of direct mapping and associative. I need LRU and modulus operation. So first I'll be dividing the given cache into two sets, that is 0, 1 is set 0, and 2, 3 belongs to set 1, and take up 4 and find the modulus to decide which set it has to belong to. Here this 0 is going to decide, or this value is going to decide where it has to sit, whether on the set 0 or on the set 1. So now the modulus operation has resulted in 0, it means this 4 will sit in the set 0. Now when I am going to get this, and here inside, once after deciding the set, the direct mapping is only used to decide the set, and after deciding the set, internally inside the set, which block number should be acquired, that is decided by the associative mapping. Now these two locations are free, and as per the associative mapping, first available free location will be allotted. So now 0 is having 4. Now we'll see, and this is a miss, so that's why we have increased the miss over here. And next there is a request for 8, which will be added to LRU, and again 8 modulus 2, the answer will be 0. It means I have to use set 0. Then among these two, so already set block number 0 is used, now we have to go with the line number 1 based on the associative mapping. So now I have acquired 1 and I am storing 8 on the line number 1. Next request for 12. Now the request for 12, again there is an increase in the miss rate because there is no 12 in the given cache. Next what I am going to do is I am going to find the modulus, and I am going to decide which set the 12 has to go. And after deciding here the set 0, now I have to apply LRU to decide which has to be replaced. You can see here 4 is the least recently used. So what I have to do now, I have to replace 4 with 12 and increase the miss rate. Next 8. When I get 8 is already available in the cache. So now I need not to perform the replace operation, just I have to increase the hit rate. And how to get to know where it is available? The set is going to tell it is available on the set 0, and now hit rate is increased and LRU is updated. Next 24 is not available in the cache. What I have to do, I have to increase the miss rate, add it to LRU, find which set it has to reside, so the set number 0 again, and out of 12 and 8, which block has to be replaced. Again this is going to tell, LRU is going to tell 12 has to be replaced. Now it's going to replace block number 12 with 24 and increase in the miss rate. Take up 16 again, it is not available in the cache. Again you have to increase the miss rate, add it to LRU, find the set number is 0, again decide which block has to be replaced. Now the LRU is going to tell 8 has to be replaced, so it's going to update 8 with 16. Now again miss rate is increased. Again, now there is a request for 36. Again, 36 is not available in the cache. What I have to do? Again, perform the same task. Increase the miss rate, add it to LRU, and LRU is going to decide which has to be replaced. 24 has to be replaced with 36, and it is done. Again, there is a request for 16. Yes, 16 I need not to replace because it is already available. Only my job is to update LRU and increase hit rate. Take up 4. 4 is not available in the cache. Again, find the set number and decide which has to be replaced, that is 36 with 4, and increase the miss rate. Next request is for 8. 8 is not there in the cache. Again, do the same task, find the set number, decide which block has to be replaced, that is 16, and update the miss rate. Next, for 12, again 12 is not there in the cache. Again, it's going to be a miss, and decide which has to be replaced on which set, that is set 0, and 4 is the block which has to be replaced, and increase the miss rate. Request is for 8, so 8 is already available in the cache. No need to perform the replace operation, just increase the hit rate by 1 and update the LRU. Next request is for 24. 24 is not there in the cache. Perform the same operation, find the set number, and decide which has to be replaced, that is 12 over here, and increase the miss rate. Next request is for 16. 16 again it's not there. Now what I have to do is decide the set number, decide which block has to be replaced. Now the block number 8 has to be replaced, and increase the miss rate. 36 again requested, but it is not there. What we are going to do here is similarly as we did, find the set number, decide which block has to be replaced, 24, and increase the. Now the last call is for 16. 16 is already there in the cache, no need to replace. Just what we have to do is here we have to perform just a task of increasing the hit rate. Now we can see that with the help of set associative, how many comparisons I was doing, only two comparators are required, 0 and 1. If I go with the previous one, the set associative, how many comparators are required, only two comparators. If I go with the previous discussion, associative mapping, so where we were using 4 lines and I need 4 comparators, here the comparator count is divided by 2, and in the direct mapping the problem was we were not well utilizing the cache, but the result if I compare with the associative mapping and set associative mapping, the number of hits in the set associative mapping is 4 and associative mapping is also 4. The number of miss in the set associative mapping is 12 and in the associative mapping is also 12. So it means by making use of set associative mapping, we can also achieve somewhat the performance of the associative mapping. With these sequences, we may got hit rate and miss rate which is equal to associative mapping. It should not be always true, but just